who wants to say something, but you want to say a few words, reflect, want to start us off? Sure. Go ahead.
So this was an awesome test to watch. I actually like the advanced degree test for a whole different reason. Like, a lot of times it's the instructors. I mean, we get to see what you guys can do. You guys are constantly showing our students how to be better versions of themselves, and today we get to see you guys come out and perform that. I really appreciate seeing that. We also a lot of times get to see the adults come out. We have all the way from like 13 years old up to, I'm sure, 25, which is awesome to see. So being able to see the well-rounded versions of what we teach here and what we actually can bring forward is such a pleasure to watch, and you guys all did an amazing job today. Nice job.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Really awesome test. We got to see the first degree black belt test a few weeks ago, and in contrast to that, I think a degree test always, or anybody testing for a degree, it comes in at a different phase in your life. You know, I think degrees just happen to fall in times of great change, personally. You know, we have graduating from college, we have going to be a senior?
Yes, sir.
Graduating this year, going to be a senior? Going to be a senior? Ninth grade? High school? Man, I didn't even know karate. And
going to be a
senior? Going to be a senior? Challenging. So importantly, challenging yourself at a time when, at least for me, as I get wiser in my years, things become more routine. You know, same coffee shop, same things on Netflix. Putting yourself out there in a different way, in a different setting. And to kind of tie this back in, you know, I really think the degrees end up standing out more clearly, maybe in the story that is your life, because they coincide with something else. I remember very distinctly for myself, third, fourth, and fifth degrees were big changes for me, not just as a martial artist, probably minimally as a martial artist, to be honest, but in terms of the direction my life took, where I went, and how it just blew the world. So, you know, take a second, now, later, maybe it's already happened, but take stock of what happened today. You see a test like this, and not everybody that you started karate with is still here. In fact, nobody might be here but you. And that's a big thing. That's a big deal for today and for the rest of your life. Congratulations. Phenomenal.
Big improvements from when we first started working.
challenge comes because you're excited about always improving. As that athlete, as that continued focus moving forward, now you have two options. Either A, you're going to either stop, or B, you can start training a different way and improving on a different area of your life, right? Once we have this, now we can take it and start to implement this system, right? If I go into a new system, I started CrossFit a couple of years ago, about a year and a half, 2 years ago. I'll tell you what, I felt like a white belt all over again. But I had that mindset of, oh, I'll get better. And I did get better. And I did. And I started to find areas in my life where I could say, hey, or in that training, where I could say, hey, I'm not a white belt anymore. I actually understand what the judge is saying or what the coach is saying. When they say do a kipping pull-up, you're like, oh, I actually understand that. I can do that. Right? Oh, this is how you're supposed to grip. Now I'm starting to elevate higher. So when you get into a new area of your life, think of that athlete skill that you learned from white belt to where you are now. Am I taking one little bit at a time, or am I just trying to be a black belt right away? Right? Don't be afraid to start over. Start something new and work your way through that system. Josh, you're awesome. Keep it up.
Such a great variety of people, personalities, skill sets, areas that areas of strength that everybody had. One thing that came out continuously was when you were hitting those pads, that's where the intensity, that power really came through. Right? I can literally feel it for Mr. Novak. I can't remember the last time I've been kicked that hard for that long over and over again. And it really shined through. And that was one of the things that we said in the back room as well, is that everybody, you let all of that come out. And sure, there were times we pause in our form and forget what we're doing, or you know, we're in the middle of a weapon and we, you know, our grip slips or something like that. But when you went out there and you showed just the foundation of your martial arts, all right, your core strikes, your core kicks, and then elevating that to the next level, that's the part that stands out to most of us as the consistent group as a whole. All right, so. The others have said the things that I want to say, but I just want to say, keep learning, all right? Keep learning, whether it is martial arts, literally. I mean, all of us can remember when we go to a new module, when we get a new weapon for the first time, that excitement that we have, all right? But sometimes that excitement wears off. So once we graduate from you know, especially from high school, but even going into college, sometimes that love of learning has already worn off, all right? And we're doing it just because we have to do it to get that piece of paper that says we did it, right? So love that learning. Love what you are doing and find that passion to continue that, right? And then the next level, as you level up throughout life, is also taking that and passing that on to other people, all right? And all of you here already help other people in some way. Of course, those with official instructor uniforms, you get paid to do it, which is a pretty awesome thing, all right? But being able to pass it on to other people and hopefully inspire them and feed their love of learning so they, too, can reach that level and pass it on to others. Right? It's a really awesome pyramid scheme right there, all right? So keep doing it, keep passing it on, because you never know, when you teach one person, you never know how many likes they're gonna change from it. All right, let's pass out some belts.